You could see me now. I'm standing tall and whole. If you could see me now, you'd know I've seen his face. If you could see me now, you'd know the pains he erased. You wouldn't want me to ever leave this place. If you could only see me now.
Precious God, we thank you this morning. We appreciate you, Lord, for you are God all alone. We have come again at your feet to hear you talk to us. Oh Lord, anoint my tongue, anoint my mouth for your perfect word. In the name of Jesus. And at the end, O Lord, your name will be glorified. Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise God. Shall we take a seat?
Isaiah 35, verse 8.
And highway shall be there. And a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. Nothing unclean shall pass over it, but it shall be called for those the way fearing men. That fool shall not end therein. That is to say, just look at me. The word of God has a standard. I said it before. If a man must make heaven, you have no option that will meet up with the standard of God. Nobody will enter heaven by mistake. If you hear me, say
amen. Amen, sir.
Nobody, I repeat, can make heaven by mistake. If you must meet heaven, you meet up with the standard of the word of God. I want to go to heaven. I want to go to heaven. You must walk it out with fear and with trembling.
Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Raise up your right hand. You will not miss heaven by any reason.
Yes.
A highway shall be there. And the way is called the way of holiness. It means it is only holy people that are permitted to go to the way. And the Bible says fools cannot go in. Idiots can't go in. Hypocrites can't go in. Backbiters can't go in. Unforgiving spirits can't go in. They are made for holy people. They are made for holy men.
The men who will be come with the standard. Is now normal to Christians. Where normal life is not called fools. Sin is not the order of the day. They clap hand for those who are professionals in fluster. Yahoo, Yahoo. Amen. That we are celebrating now. Parents, now encourage our children to leave school and enter Yahoo, Yahoo.
Satan.
You think that you will just go for free. The Bible says, whatever a man soweth.
And the scripture said that the way the sinner, in fact, the sinner must not go unpunished.
And currently, you are tempted to clap up for Yahweh.
How old are you? No, say 27 years. Go and see. My man, I can keep. Believers, where does it work? It does not do anything. It bought a land and it's building a house. And a father, happy, celebrate a son who is putting sorrow on them in another family. Any father that clap hand for the son for Yahweh, any mother that clap hand for the daughter for prostitute, both of you will land in hellfire. They are righteous. Bible says in Revelation, the Bible says, those who are dead will rise. The Bible says, the sea will forget their own. The Bible says, the hell will also forget. I begin to wonder, can the hellfire forget? Yes.
Read that verse again.
First
you are not born again. If you are born again, you know what it means to take 1% of alcohol. 1% of alcohol. I will see my man. They will buy me, they will go and buy Pami, look for Pami on this morning. What is the difference between a man who drank Pami and a man who drank beer? Church, are you with me? What are the difference between a man who drank Pami and a man who drank beer? What are the difference between a man who drank Pami and a man who drink 4 liters or 3 liters of a gogoro and 4 liters of water?
Yes, sir.
Any man or woman
God. The Bible says, the righteous, it means you are standing, Christ standing with God, make you bold as a lion. Can I talk to you? See, when it comes, first thing you will talk is enjoyment. First thing you will talk is many things. You are enjoying yourself. But gradually, you are going slowly to death. John chapter 16, when you read that, the Bible says, look at what happened in verse 16.
As she said,
the Philistine are upon you.
Samson.
I will arouse out of my sleep. The way I used to do it before. He was thinking that the same way he used to do it before. In the same way. I will arouse out of my sleep. Go ahead. God was warning. He's still continuing there. But one day, he heard the footstep of God by him. And he was thinking that, yes, I can still feel God's presence all over me. God is still walking by me. Listen, he never knew that was his step God used to walk away. He was hearing himself. He never knew that God just walked away. He thought that God was walking with him. The Bible says, Delilah says something. The blessings are there. He said, don't worry. The same way I used to rise before, I will get up, the chains will be broken, I will kill all of them. And the Bible says, when he rise that time, he never knew that the presence of God had left him. Church, sin kills slowly. It kills slowly. It puts you to a place where you never expect. It puts you to death slowly. You don't expect it. I love it. Please don't be like it. You will never end up halfway.
Amen.
What stops something halfway will not stop you.
Amen.
If your amen is loud, the person I'm talking to. Sin divides and disqualifies us from fellowshipping with God. It divides. And he was using hand to beckon on the Philistine.
God is saying, just go this mountain, just go this mountain. We have told you the way to our life. And the Bible says, he came, the sheep said, Lord. And the Bible says, the ladder afflicted us. By that time, the presence of God has left. You know why? He has won first time, won the second time, won the third time, he refused to hear. So since he refused to hear, God walked away. So then we had to go on. May the Lord not walk away from you.
Amen.
Your amen is looking for my trouble.
Amen.
And the Bible says the devil took over. It was when the devil took over that the devil was able to handle what Samson to the Philistine. They know that when Samson prayed to God, something will happen. What they do first is they quickly remove his eyes. They know that with his eyes, this man can be bad. So without eyes, they don't get what they do. So they quickly remove his eyes. They remove his eyes, the two eyes, and they get blind. They call it a mock of something. According to a character, okay, then we go for Jacob. May you not fall from grace.
Amen.
I said, may you not fall from grace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, may you not fall from grace.
Amen.
Understand? You don't really cost your generation. Hello, church. Nobody cost that person. That person don't really cost his own generation. You know where I fear God? Exodus 20. When God said, anyone that serve idol, I will visit the iniquity of the father and the mother upon the children. When the children there, when they there, which is their grandchildren and their grandchildren. When they were committed. So what you are doing now, your children may not be there. The stealing, the cheating, the game for play now. Your children may not be there. They will come and suffer for it. That is the name of the fear. So since you are not considered, you are not pity for yourself, you are supposed to be pity for our children. Anytime you sit down, and we are talking about the state of the nation. Mommy always say one word. It's till I let my children and the son for and the spirit for. I say yes. Even the Bible told us. He said that day. Go to that woman with a sucking child. Bible tell us. So if you don't value your life, you should be able to value your children. Better ask you a question. Jesus will tell you, to whom I love, I chastise. To whom I love, I rebuke. But you say you love your children, but you are clapping hands for them or evil. You say you love your children, you are clapping hands for them to fall into a fire, to fall into the sword. And you know, all those things are against the Nigerian constitution. That anyone for this court, if you don't have level, they will go to jail. Anyone with a cash now would have sent to 10 years in prison. 10 years plus the age where they are going to be. You don't think about those words. May the Lord deliver us. Four times of sin. Four times of sin. Number one, the inward sin. There are sins that we call inward sins. These are the sins others don't know about. They are all. The one you know, the one your wife don't know, your pastor don't know,
Number two, we have the actual sin. The one everybody can easily notice. Ah, you don't get below. She's pregnant. But as you see her now, you know, I know she's in there, like, you don't go to where. Actual sin. The one that can easily be noticed in character by your school. We need to talk to them, we need to talk to them. Actual sin. And we have another one that is called secret sin. The one that nobody knows. You do it in the dark. You cover it. Only you do it with Satan. Nobody knows about it. You went there and do the thing, come back with it. Secret sin. May the Lord deliver you on that. I said, may the Lord deliver you and I.
Yeah.
Lastly, number four is called a common sin. The one that is common to almost everybody. Where are you? I'm over here. And where you are in Tedoshim. I'm going to divide this one. $50. And everybody knows that it's $30. You think you are fully in them. You are fully yourself. Where are you? We travel and we're not at home. You think you are fully them. You are fully yourself. Come on, say. It's come on, no more. And the Bible says, no unrighteous shall go to damage. No unrighteous shall go to damage. I was still praying.
Yes, sir.
I only know you in the church. Outside church, who are you? Am I talking to the people?
Yes, sir.
I only know you here as a daughter of the Word of God. I only know you by face. I look at the continent of your appearance and I call you daughter. It's only God that searches the heart, that knows the heart of woman. Be as you are. So we just come and tell you. Because now where you pay, let me not. Now your level, let me not. When somebody just come for God, close your eyes. If you reach there, I just pray. Doctor, they say you blend. I just pray. You don't pray. Here, you do pray. I'll be 10,000. Close your eyes. So this man, he was blind, according to the story, to the mother, he was blind for the womb. How old are you, Woga?
10 years.
There's nothing the Lord can do. There's nothing the Lord can do. The Lord will perform miracle. In the name of Jesus, receive your sight. Open your eye.
many of you. Yeah, mama was going out. One man going up, hey, mama go, papa. And I pull over. He said, I wanted to come and see you. On Sunday is my birthday. You hear me, mommy? You hear Statistic and brother, happy?
Yes, sir.
Happy? Just so.
Yes.
Hear Statistic and brother, I begin to wonder. In my spirit, although my vision and I always do. How can you be doing baby in the church where there's no roof? How can you be doing baby in the church where there's temporary structure? I'm not kicking against baby. How can you be doing a baby in the church where church does altar is naked? At least if you don't spend money on that baby, the least is $10,000. Have you? Can do something in the altar of the Lord. Beautify those altar and God will beautify you.
Yes, sir.
When God wanted to test you, in your test, many failed. You now make God a liar and you don't know that his time is too short, his time is too delayed. That you needed a man that will be very fast. Go and will come back. When the Lord has mercy on you, you will start afresh if you don't die there. You will start to come to me. May the Lord help us in Jesus.
Amen.
As I know, a man started the first year. He said, I want to know how many times I come to church in a year. And he got a very dark bottle. And anytime he goes to church for the week, you go and drop one seed of corn inside. At least you go to church 3 times in a week, have you? 3 times in a week. In our order, 3 times in a week. So other church 2 times. Monday, Sunday and Wednesday. Our order at least 3 or 4 times. What does it? We come Sunday, Bible study and prayer meeting 3 times. Let's forget every other fellowship. So he was dropping 3 corn every week inside the bottle. Finally, at the end of the year, not that he made a mistake, he was dropping it. Finally, at the end of the year, he brought out the bottle and said, he wanted to know how many times he was in church in a week, sorry, in a year. And he brought out the bottle on the floor and he discovered it was only 5 cup that was there. Fine. What are you saying? Only 2 weeks now, not past time. Okay? 2 weeks now, but we don't pass time. I want what is going to happen. I was not praying, God. I just want to go to misery. And they don't appear. Say, you don't need to stay long. I need to come and send you your issue for time. So you are arguing. He said, yes, and that is the only 5 times you came for time. That was second. Say, everyone now will come on time. So it's only 5 times in a year you will talk for time. So every other one gave them one. And the Lord left him. He died to wake up.
So it was calculated. Maybe it was maybe at least I will get like 60 times or like 50 times. God said, you don't need to stay long. I come to settle issue. You are arguing. That is only 5 times you came on time to the church. After 365 days. Only 5 times. So the any other one you came late. So anyone that comes today, suppose not to. And the man fell down. The Lord went to. And many of us are like that. You can't have any time to come to church. You can't have any time to go to church. And God didn't record anyone. Because many of you came here with gossip. Many of you came here with grudges of heart. Many of you came here with an unforgiving spirit. Many of you came here with backbiting. Many of you came here with hatred. Sir. Isaiah 35, verse 8. The Bible says the highway is only for holy men and women. Stand by your feet. Ask him the grace that you need in this journey. The grace to finish work. Give him the heart of repentance. Show your children at this table. Come show your children at this wickedness. Come show your children. reveal one name. Thank God is great.
If you could see me now, I'm standing tall and whole. If you could see me now, you know I've seen his face. If you could see temporary trials have worked out for my good.